Hi again. Looking at how to calculate air pipes or vents and overflow pipe sizes for your diagrammatic for your fuel oil system. So what we're looking at in this particular scenario is when you look at any kind of tank that you have on a ship, it has to have an air vent. That's so that the air that's in the tank can come out and you're not creating a vacuum that would be inside of the tank. In addition to that, normally we see overflow pipes as well attached to tanks, so that the overflow scenario is set up so that fuel coming in, once it gets up to a certain amount, will flow into the overflow instead of flowing out through the vent and onto the main decks where the vent openings would be. So in our case, I've designed here a little scenario of a fuel oil tank that has an 80 millimeter pipe feeding into it. So in this particular case, I'm considering how fuel would be going into the tank. Typically, what's happening here is you got your standard velocity created by the pipe size you design with, and of course, you got a flow rate moving in. So when we look at how big the air pipe is, it's typically bigger than this particular pipe. A lot of experienced designers will just go up one pipe size, but I want you guys to learn how to calculate this setup without having to just make the generalization. So in this scenario, I've given a situation where we've got our 80 millimeter nominal pipe size and it's schedule 40. And from the pipe charts, I have indicated that this ID is 77.92 millimeters. So what we're looking at here is we're looking at that ID across here, okay, 77.92 millimeters. And in order for us to do the calculation on this, we actually had to look at the area of the circle that would be like taking a slice out of the pipe. Because according to the rules, in order to calculate the size for these two pipes, we actually have to add 25% to the area. Okay, so to the area of the pipe. And you, if you want some clarification on this, you can find this in part 5 of Lloyd's rules under section 13, I think, chapter 13. So when we are looking at this scenario, first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to calculate using A equals pi d squared over 4. Okay, that's your standard area of a circle for when you have the diameter. So in my case now, I'm going to calculate pi for 77.92 squared over 4. And that's going to give me an area, a calculated area for this particular pipe at 4768. That's 4,768.56 millimeters. Okay, so now what we have to do is add 25% to that. So my new area of my pipe, and remember, it is imperative that these sizes always be bigger. So I'm going to say my new area is going to be 4768.56 times 1.25, and that gives me a new area of 5,960.70 millimeters. Okay, and that's millimeters squared, of course, because we're talking about an area. Now what I want to do is go back and calculate my new ID for my larger pipe. So in doing so, I go D is equal to the square root of 4 times A divided by pi. And in this case, I'm looking at the square root of 4 times 5,960.7 over pi. And my new ID is going to be 87.12 millimeters. Okay, so now I go back to my pipe chart that I've shown you guys before, and once again, this is online because it's very small. And what I'm going to be looking at is I'm going to be looking down the side to see what internal diameter I can use. So from this chart, from the pipe chart, I get two options for schedule. 40, because I'm only ever looking at schedule 40 pipe for my die, my setups, I can use an NPS of 90 or an NPS of 100. And when I look at these two setups, why I've given you two options is the inside diameter of schedule 40 pipe for 90 mils is 90.12 millimeters, which would work, but sometimes 90 mil pipe is not used. It's always a little harder pipe to get. It's considered a 3.5. So sometimes you will see in the yard that they will go up to an NPS 100, which is considered 4-inch pipe and is readily available. You can use either because these are new designs and we're just practicing, but your, your air pipe, in this particular case, for me, I'm going to use 100 millimeters, and I would write here on my diagrammatic 100 millimeters up here, and if I was to put the pipe size in here, I would have 100 millimeters there. I'm more interested for this application that you do the calculations. If your drawing's starting to get a bit cluttered, that's okay, but that's where they would be placed. Anyway, I hope that was easy. Of course, the setup for the overflow is both the same, and I look forward to seeing your work. Thank you.